Hi, welcome. In this video, we'll take a look at the latest Logic Pro 11.2 update, and there's some really important stuff in this new update, like improved stem splitting. You can split into more different stem parts, and the quality is also improved in the stem splitting. And one of the more important features in this update, at least to me, and I know it's going to be important to many of you out there, is the new Flashback Capture that can capture audio in the background. There's also some other small features, like we have a longer faders in the mixer, which means it's going to be more easy to make smooth and gradual changes and more precise adjustments with the volume faders. In the new update, there's also an improved search, which will make it super easy to find and select specific tracks in your project. And there's also a new sound pack from Tosin Asabi. And if you don't know Tosin, he's the guitar player in Animals as Leaders. And I actually was lucky to catch a live gig with Animals as Leaders when I was at NAMM in 2020. And boy, it was a nice live show. Okay, so yeah, let's dive into the new features. Okay, so before we continue, I'd like to say that a lot of people watch my videos but are not subscribed to my channel. So please, if you enjoy my content here on YouTube, please hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so that you get a notice when I release new videos. And that way you also support my channel and we can drive this forward and make more awesome videos for you. Thanks. Okay, so let's begin trying out the quality of the stem splitter and see how the new stem splitting works. So here we have a track called The Precious Discovery. It's a metal track because I wanted to see how it tackles guitars. And on this first track, it's going to be some acoustic guitars and vocals and some keyboards. So we'll take a listen to the raw original. Okay, so let's see how the stem splitting handles this type of track. So we're gonna right click and select the stem splitter. You also find it down here in processing, stem splitter. And as you can see, we get more options here. We have vocals, drums, bass, guitar, piano, and other as stems. And the default preset here is separate all stems, but you can also select only to get an a cappella, so we get only the vocals, or we can select like instrumental, which will only be the submix of the instruments. And then vocals and instruments, which will be vocals and the submix, and some other options. But we're gonna separate all stems and apply. And yeah, that was pretty quick, so let's hear the quality of like the full submix of all the stems.
Afraid to let it fall into the wrong hands. I'm an endless burden.
That's a very good quality vocal stem splitting.
There is something I wanted to tell you.
And let's hear the drums. So there's a little bit more artifacts here in the drums, especially in the, it's a high register. But we also have to take into consideration that this is from an MP3, and you often get more like degrading in the high regions if you have a compressed file, obviously. And it seems it has a harder time to process the higher register. The kick sounds all right. Let's listen to the bass. Also very good split, and then we have the guitars. Yeah, just beautiful. Not a lot of artifacts in the guitars. I think it sounds pretty clean for being like a stem split. And then we have the others, which is probably gonna be like the synths in this track. Also quite good split. Okay, so let's try a more busy part in this track. So here we have more distorted guitars. This is the chorus of the track. And some growl vocals. So let's try that one, stem split. So that took a little bit longer than our first split. I have no idea why it took longer, but let's see how this turns out. Pretty good split. Let's listen to the drums. Again, it seems like the toms and the snare and the kicks and everything sounds really nice. But then the like high register stuff like cymbals and hi-hats and stuff are a little bit more like degraded. But maybe it's that it messes up how the high register is supposed to be split. Or it's messing it with some other instruments. Let's listen to the bass. Sounds very realistic and like natural. Yeah, guitar's also pretty decent. Not super high quality, but we have to take in consideration it's a pretty dense mix there, especially during the chorus section. It's like a lot of instruments at the same time. And then the rest. There's some simple synth layers. So that's for the stem extraction. So all in all, I think it does a very, very good job on extraction the vocals and also the guitars there on the tracks. It's definitely the best stem extraction that I've heard to date. So big kudos to the new Logic Pro update. Okay, so what I personally think is one of the most cool features here in Logic 11.2 is the new Flashback Capture feature. While we could capture like MIDI recordings in the past, if we just hit play here and didn't hit record, but we play something like. And then afterwards we could press Shift and R and we would capture the MIDI. But with 11.2, we can also do this with audio. To gain access to the Flashback Capture, we can just right-click in our toolbar and select the Customize Control Bar. And you find it under Transport Flashback Capture. So let's activate that, and we can see an additional like recording button here. So let's select this piano track. I'm using the Songwriter piano preset, and we're also going to select with Shift Select here this vocal track. But we're not going to hit record, we're just going to play back the track, and afterwards we're going to try this Shift and R with both the MIDI and also the audio track. There is something I wanted to tell you. Though I'm afraid to see it fall into the wrong hands. And now I'm going to press Shift and R, and there we have the MIDI. And then we can press Shift and R again, and there we have the audio. There is something I wanted to tell you. Though I'm afraid to see it fall into the wrong hands. So this is going to be a huge time saver if you're just like playing back your track and trying different song melodies and stuff. And then when you find something that you like, just hit Shift and R and you're going to capture that. Another really exciting feature in the Flash Capture, except this audio recording, is that you can also record MIDI while in stop mode. So say that we're just practicing something, or we're just fooling around maybe. And then you can always press Shift and R. And there we have the MIDI. And I really feel that these features with Flashback Capture is going to be a huge time saver, at least to me in my audio production and audio work. Because sometimes you just practice to a part and you just sing, and sometimes you nail that really good take and you felt that, man, I wish I was recording. How about you? Okay, the next exciting feature to check out is the long extended faders. So we're going to press X to go into the mix view, and you'll find the long extended faders in the view menu, and go to long faders. And bam, there we have the extended faders, and with a more granular scale for measuring where we have the volume. Broken pieces in a sign, scattered dreams where our hearts were torn. But in the dark, I hear you call. Through the chaos, we undo it all. Yeah, it definitely feels more natural to have this extended range in the volume faders, and more range to work with when doing automation. And feels definitely more like a real mixer compared to the previous shorter faders. Next, let's talk about the search function and how you can search for tracks and regions in your arrangement. So let's go up to track in the menu and select search and select track. And let's write guitar. And there we can see all the different guitar tracks in our arrangement. And we can also search for tracks numbers. Let's search for 11, 15, 8, 17. So that's also another way to find your tracks if you have like a large arrangement with hundreds of tracks. Yeah, so finally it's time to take a listen to some of those new sounds in the updated sound packs. And I think we're going to listen to some of those Tosin loops. So we go into the loop browser and we're going to search for Tosin. Thank you. And there you can hear that the typical Tosin, like picking and very interesting picking technique. Yeah, so Apple definitely hired the right guy to add these kind of percussive rhythmical guitar patches or guitar loops in Logic Pro, and these are definitely gonna come in handy for like backdrops to any type of track, be it EDM, rock, pop or hip-hop or whatever type of genre. These are some really excellent loops. And of course, you can just transpose these if they're in the wrong key. But if it's a minor, it's of course going to continue being minor. And yeah, a lot of possibilities with these loops. And yeah, so I think this is a really important update to Logic Pro. And as I mentioned, my personal favorite is definitely the Flashback Capture. So I can capture any type of like a guitar performance or vocal performance when I forget to hit record or when I just practice. So what's your personal favorite here in the Logic Pro 11.2 update? Or maybe you find some other feature that's missing from Logic Pro. Please let me know here in the comments.